Okay, all. I just checked and I see that the installer has completed on our virtual machine. So let's go back. We're going to remote desktop back into Hokusai, our virtual machine, and we're going to complete this install. So while you were away, after it completed the first time, after I ran Vagrant up, the very next thing that I ran was Vagrant Reload. So, Vagrant Reload will cause the machine to reboot, essentially. It's a reboot command. And so, let's just open VirtualBox and see what we have. So, see this? This doesn't look like a terminal. This looks like it has a desktop environment. So, and it does. So, let's just go on to our new desktop environment. We can go on to this machine using the command line. With something like this, Vagrant SSH, and it will SSH into our newly created virtual machine. But because we need to load some API keys and be a little bit more interactive with the desktop, and we have a desktop environment, let's just use it. So I'm launching the desktop environment. And so our password is Vagrant. And so we're loading our desktop. There we go. So here's the setup information that it's like the starter for a full desktop install of Ubuntu 20. So we're just going to go through this. Legal notices. No, we're not turning on location services. We don't need to be snooped on anymore. This is great. We can install all of this extra software too and make it like a real desktop experience. So thanks for letting us know, but we're done. Okay. So the very next thing we need to do is back up for a second. And let me go back to our GitHub page and point out something. So once we ran Vagrant up and we did the reload, we got a working desktop. But our Bada Bing software is not going to run, because we need to load our API keys. So we need to set up all of these in advance. So while this was actually provisioning, I've already loaded these API keys onto my instance. Well, presumptively. Did I really? Not really, because I had it from before. But while the machine is loading, you want to log into Google, set up a developer API key. You want to log into Open Weather Maps and get an API key. This may actually take a couple of hours to start working. So don't be freaked out if it doesn't work right away. You want a free API key. Newsdata.io, same thing. Just log in, get the API key. There was no necessary delay with them that I've noticed, but there may be. And also ChatGPT. And here's the URL. So just go there and set up your ChatGPT, get your API key, and that's where we're at with this step, because we need to load those API keys into our instance. Now, for Google Developer, it's important that you set up the API key on the console, because you don't need the key itself. You need to set it up in the console. It's gonna when we set up the Google Cloud SDK in a second, it's going to query the console and find out what your API key is. So you don't need this. But for our actual parameters file, you need these. So let's go look at the parameters file before we actually update the parameters file. So here's the information that you need. So here's where the APIs go. So I mentioned you need 4, but you only need to load 3 into this. Your weather, so open weather API goes here. Your news goes here. And your ChatGPT API key goes here. So when you ask for my weather, it'll go here. When you ask for random news, it'll go here. When you ask, where's the Burj Khalifa, it'll go here. Okay. The other part is when you say my weather or local weather, computer, what's my local weather, it's going to need your zip code. So specify your zip code here. And when I mentioned about the actual accents, here are the accents right here. It's controlled with this localization parameter. This is an Australian accent, com.au. But if you change this to US, this is the United States, no accent, accent. This would be very British. And this would be a very proper Indian accent. So there's how you control how your actual bot responds. Initially, when you're setting this up, I would just leave it as it is, and then you can always change it later. So just when you set this up, just go in and carefully edit your zip code and also update your API keys to 3. And the fourth one, I'm going to show you how do we get the fourth key. So, all right, back over to our desktop environment. It's going to ask us if we want to upgrade and don't upgrade and leave this alone. And we're going to go here. We're going to open the terminal. And for the sake of making our lives easier in the future, we're going to, let's see, can I do it from here? There's a way to pin this to your favorites. You should do it. I'm connected to my virtual machine with a Mac remote desktop session. So I don't know all the keys, and that's one of the things. But if you're using Windows and you're connecting to this, there's no problem. There's an option there to pin this to the side, and you should, because you'll be using the terminal frequent. Okay. So how do we get that fourth API key from Google in here? So here's what we do. So the basic software is there, but we need to link it to our Google account. Using the desktop environment is better. So let's just type it in. It's gcloud init. So this is going to start the process of linking your local Google account with your Google Developer API keys to this Google Cloud SDK, which Bada Bing needs to transcribe your messages. So here we go. It's going to open up Firefox for us, so we don't have to. But if it doesn't, if it doesn't open up Firefox. You can copy paste this into a browser, but it did it for us. So I'm going to just sign in. Hopefully I will remember my password correctly. Now, I have multi-factor authentication turned on, so my computer just chimed in the background saying, is this a good person to let in? So I'm going to say, yes, it's me. And so now this two-step verification has been completed, and I'm going to go move down here, and I'm going to allow access to my Google Developer API keys, which were set up in advance. So you're now authenticated with Google Cloud CLI. Great. This is what we want to see. If we don't see this, things aren't going to work right. Your messages won't be transcribed. But there's an additional step because in the command line here, you have to pick which API key you want to connect this project to. I have plenty of API keys on my Google Developer account, and the one I set up for this is transcription, it's called. So I'm going to pick my transcription API. And there we go. So that's the last part of this. So I'm going to pause the video briefly and actually copy over my real API keys to this. And we're going to run bada bing.